What if I told you that everything that you went through is actually preparing you for your next in the community? What if I told you that everything that you went through is actually preparing you for your next in your business? And what if I told you that everything that you went through is actually preparing you for your next in your life? You'd probably look at me and say, "Dr. Allie, girl, you're crazy. What do you mean everything I went through? What do you mean? Even all the pain, all the hurt, all the sorrow, all of the isolation? How is that preparing me for what's now? How is that preparing me for what's next?" Hi, everyone. I'm Dr. Allie, and I help moms to simply launch their own brands. I specifically work with autism moms, special needs moms, or moms who have been through some major challenges in their lives, where they've had to release their dreams and let everything go, actually giving everything to their kiddos. And in that space where they've completely forgot about their real purpose in showing up in life. Today, we're going to talk a little bit about how being an autism mom really helped to catapult my life as an entrepreneur. I would have never thought these two things had anything to do with each other. I mean, 13 years ago, when Zachary was diagnosed with being on the autism spectrum, well, that was the first when I started to notice his characteristics, where he was lining things up, even his Cheerios, when he was turning the lights on and off. And I started to notice that his conversation levels changed, the interaction, less engagement. He was between 16 to 18 months around that time. And as a speech language pathologist and audiologist, I saw the signs, but I didn't really want to see the signs. I spent many years in grief, in bargaining mode, all of Elizabeth Kubler-Ross's grieving methods, where I went from denial, bargaining, anger, until finally coming to the space of acceptance. But acceptance helped me to realize that these powerful lessons that I'm going to share with you today, these lessons are what you are going to use, what I use, what we can use to get us through the next steps. What now? Whether it's in your life or in your business, then you may want to start some of this right now. So, what does autism have to do with business? I mean, these are two different things. Remember when I started off at the beginning by letting you know that everything that we have been through before, every obstacle, every challenge, even the pain that we have surfaced on the other side. So what now? Welcome to the other side. That has prepared us for where we are right now and is preparing us for what's next. Through my process and through being Zachary's mom, yeah, he's now 15 years old, I began to learn that there were certain things that helped me to realize that I was complicating the world of being an entrepreneur and being a mom. I was making everything hard, harder than it needed to be. For years, I sat and I made the idea of even getting started with this concept, this dream I had. I really wanted to start a business, but I didn't know how to do it. I know I'm pretty good at what I'm trained at in terms of communication, but how do you start a full-blown business, especially when parenting a child with special needs? Some of you may be thinking about this right now, since 3% of our workforce is leaving, they're leaving their jobs right now. It's called the Great Resignation. And more are stepping into entrepreneurships and starting their own businesses. So guess what? I learned that instead of complicating things, I'm going to actually look at this kid, look at Zachary, and start to learn how is he keeping such a simple life? Like, I began to learn tools and strategies that he would use every day. And then I started to use some of those same tools and strategies, I'm going to share some with you, into how I can now put that into my business and create what's now a full-fledged successful business. And most of my frameworks are from what I learned from Zachary. Isn't that pretty cool? All right, the first powerful lesson I had to learn was we need to accept our differences, y'all. Accepting differences made me realize that if I wanted Zachary to be like everyone else, then I was going to do the same thing with my business. When he was younger, I wanted him to fit into the mold. I wanted him to do what everyone else was doing. You know how we are? We wanted everything to be the same. I'm expecting the same thing out of him. I wanted him to do everything of what the other children was doing. And when he didn't do it, I felt disappointed. What I was realizing was I was trying for him to fit into a mold when we were created to stand out. Now, a lot of us may be doing the same thing in our businesses. We want to fit in with everyone else. We want to do what everyone else is doing, not realizing that what will make us memorable as a business, what will make us memorable as a CEO, is when we actually stand out and stand in our uniqueness. What makes us different from everyone else? So I thought to myself, if I can do this as an entrepreneur, instead of fitting in, instead of doing what everyone else is doing, how about I stand out from the crowd? How about I actually get heard through that noisy crowd? Simply by embracing my own uniqueness, my own differences, my own quirks, the things that make me just me, and the things that make you just you. What I began to realize with the clients that came to me through coaching was that the experiences that I had was what actually made me stand out from the crowd, from the rest of what everyone else was doing. It gave that extra likability factor. It gave that extra stickiness. And it made me as an entrepreneur more memorable. Thanks, Zachary, for that powerful lesson. The second most amazing lesson, another powerful lesson I learned from Zachary, was truly stepping into being myself. Like really understanding that if I was going to be like anyone else, that it really wasn't going to stand out. But even through being myself, I'm a pretty simple person and I like to be direct. I like to be straight to the point. The second lesson, besides being myself, was how do I begin to be more direct? How do I take simple steps towards getting things completed? Now, when I speak to Zachary and I get a little long-winded, he would say, "Mom, take it easy," because you can see he was getting confused in the mix. Now, if there's one thing you need to learn about children on the spectrum, now remember, it's a spectrum. So some are verbal and some are not. But what I learned from Zachary was that he liked for me to be straight to the point. He needed short directions and he needed things that avoided all of the extra fluff so that he can actually pay attention, actually execute, and actually create the results. So whether they were slow or whether they were fast in terms of his final growth or the growth in a specific area, it was his growth at his pace. When I began to use the same strategy while coaching my other moms, when they were developing their businesses, instead of me trying to sound all like I know everything and I had to give all the 50 million directions, what they wanted from me was the simple, Allie, was where I was before, was how to be more direct and get straight to the point. Stop the fluff. So as leaders, let's start adapting that space where we don't need to do the extra talking above anyone. We just need to keep it super simple. Straight directions, 1, 2, 3. That's our guidelines at home. And those are the same guidelines I use when speaking either to an employee, a family member, a friend. I've just learned how to just keep it super simple. Take it back to the basics. And then the third powerful lesson I learned through being an autism mom, and this one was key to it all, was keeping routines, establishing routines, and also making sure that we knew what came first, what comes next, what happens last, and then what do we need to do after that. See, Zachary needed it by steps, and he needed to know it in a routine. And the more we kept the routine, the more we created a system, the easier it was for him to get his task complete and for him to meet that objective. So let's try and do more of that. Let's try and create more systems so that we are not putting all of this extra energy. Our employees are not feeling as if it's a lot and they may forget and it's going around and it's chaos. With a system and with a routine, it helps to reduce the overwhelm. So create systems, routines, checklists, and things that will help to make your business to start, to grow, and to flourish, where you get to keep your energy intact. Hey, I took what I learned. I learned it from Zachary, and I began to tweak it, move it into the world of entrepreneurship, and I saw results. Hence the reason, that's where I go back to. Whenever I'm looking for the next lesson, like what do I need to apply towards entrepreneurship, I just really start paying attention to Zachary. So that's how I want to leave you with today. I want to leave you with these three simple, powerful tools. Learn how to accept differences. 2, be super direct. Be direct in what you have to say. And then 3, use routines, systems, and checklists to help to make it super simple in your business and in your life. Zachary always tells me, stop making it complicated, Mom. Keep it simple.